a seasoned player out of the blue. This game is too easy. What do I do? A new player with his step unsteady. For this game, I was never ready. What if I reveal to you now, before you get bored or bit? The sandbox can be changed mid-game the way you consider fit. Dear viewer, take this informative video as a bribe for you to like, share and subscribe. Welcome. Did you start the game with certain questionable sandbox settings? Did those settings have become now too easy for you or too much to chew? Of course, you can just start a new character. But what if you've become too attached to your current character? That survived for so long or spent too much time on building your aesthetic base. A new game is just too much time. I present to you the sandbox file. It is either in the sandbox folder or named after a default playstyle you chose. Did you know that you can edit this file? About the values shown in the file? Do not worry, friend. I'll explain. There are just numbers with a decimal separator, the checkboxes, and the drop-down menu. This is just a binary file with the important data being visible for us mere mortals. Now I'm going to show you a few tests. The zombie speed. For this, I started with a random speed for zombies. Pay attention to the speed of their movement. Some are walkers, while some are sprinting towards me. Now quit the game and open mapsand.bin in your favorite text editor. And change this value next to zombielore.speed from 4 to 3. And save the file and exit. After that, load your save file. Note in the thumbnail that the zombie is sprinting. But as the game loads, you can see the zombies are now much slower. When they are close, they do move faster. But when they are further away, their movement is slower to the point that they are not much of a threat anymore. But are you a pro gamer? Do you enjoy doing things the hard way and flexing your e-pin online? Well, just as before, open mapsand.bin in your favorite text editor and change the value from 3 to 1, then save and exit. As you can see, they instantly get faster and more of a threat. I intentionally did not enable God mode, so I can feel more immersed. The zombie population test. I started the save with a small population. There were literally one or two zombies along the way. I started running on the road and very few zombies spawned. Then I quit, changed the value to max, which is 4, and re-entered the game. Now, obviously, after loading, the town was still unpopulated. And that's because these chunks I'm running through were already loaded before I quit the game. But after running for a while, new chunks with fresh zombies appeared. So many zombies. It was like people gathering at a fun fair. Everything was so alive, yet so dead. Cool. The game froze. For the multi-hit test. Started without multi-hit and yes, it was a bit hard, as expected. Then, after editing the value to true, surprise, an error. Lesson, always backup your save. Using the alternate launcher, I saw the exception error. The string was being interpreted as true and blank instead of only true. Looking back at the file, we remember that this is a binary file. That symbol before the value is a byte. The byte before true is a 4. And the byte before false is a 5. That just tells the game how many characters it needs to read to get the value correctly. To modify, use a hex editor. But I am lazy and I will just delete this file. Hold Alt key and press 04, then release, and voila! Behold, multi-hit enabled. The day length test. Just as you can edit the speed of zombies, you can also edit the speed of time. This one is straightforward. Started with 15 minutes day length, then tried with a 5-hour day length. Good news is that the hunger stat decay scaled with the day length, so it is safe to change this parameter. The helicopter event. I started another save with no helicopter event. By day 6 to 8, no helicopter showed up. Then I changed the settings, and it took a while to show up, but it did in the end. You can also change this back. This is useful if you're tired of often helicopter visits. Now it's your turn. Did this video help you in any way? If yes, then share this video and spread the knowledge. And let me know in the comment section. Did you crank up the difficulty? Did you make the game more chill? Or did you troll your friend by swapping his map sand.bin? Thank you for watching and see you later.